The World Bank put out a report saying that Rwanda had met the Millennium Development Goals.
From the start of struggle and after that and another struggle of reconstruction of our country, we have been single-minded about doing the best we can for ourselves, for our country, and reverse the bad history. For any country or leaders in that country, there has to be a vision. There has to be a strategy to realize that vision. And the different plans thereof have to be carried through. There are no shortcuts. There are no two ways about it. We don't allow Africans to move across borders and within Africa. We don't allow goods to move. We allow it at the rate of 17%. And yet, everyone's intention is to see Africa move forward, develop fast. And so there is a contradiction, in a sense, in our quest for prosperity, for development, and at the same time, some of the very things we know we can do and have to do in order for things to happen. But we see very little in that regard. A small example of how, you know, proud Africa should be, and I was proud for that. In Rwanda, we you know, inaugurated a very huge complex that had been constructed over a number of years. And when I was there, asking those who put it together and who were behind it, I found three people, engineers. One was Rwandese, another one was Kenyan, another one was Zimbabwean. And the Kenyan had come from Kenya, the Rwandese was there, the Zimbabwean had come from London. But these were, so when we're talking about skills, I think there are many Africans who can, but we need to give them this opportunity, we need to bring them in, we need to, you know, move on and do things and make them happy.